Mr. Mears finds it rather ironic that the Tradewind security programs engaged in by both local and U.S. law enforcement authorities in June 2013 were conducted after the U.S. Human Rights Report came out on April 19th that same year. The former National Security Minister also finds it strange that while the Prime Minister quoted the U.S. Ambassador to the Eastern Caribbean as confirming that Police Commissioner Vernon Francois' visa had not been revoked, he did not quote any U.S. official as stating that America had no confidence in the results of the coroner's inquest. Mr. Mears has planted the blame on the recent actions by the Prime Minister, which he believes triggered a reaction from the United States. He says in no way did he or anyone in the former government make any statement that would incite the so-called unlawful killings. In fact, as far as he is concerned, there were no extrajudicial killings.
He is suggesting in his comments that the Americans are not happy with the outcome, or they're not satisfied with the judicial system in St. Lucia. Is that what he is indicating? And therefore he's going to go to IMPACTS to bring in investigators to do work that has already been done by the coroners in St. Lucia. So is he saying that the Americans told him, the same way he said that the Americans told him that they had not revoked the visa of the Commissioner of Police, is he telling us that the Americans told him that they're not satisfied with the judicial system in St. Lucia? Because from reading his report or his message, he's saying that he's assuming that that is the reason. He never said that they told him so.
Mr. Mears also spoke about the hit list, which Dr. Anthony referred in his address. The Prime Minister claims to have seen the list while in opposition, but Mr. Mears says there was no such list. According to the former National Security Minister, what there was a sharing of intelligence among police departments.
And I'm disturbed that the Prime Minister would, first of all, be making statements about a hit list and repeating that he saw a hit list while he was in opposition. I am not aware of any hit list, because the time he's mentioning is while I was minister responsible for national security in St. Lucia. Every police department or unit or outfit in every part of the world share intelligence among departments of the police. And as far as I am aware, the information that was being shared was among police departments, because it made no sense that the persons of interest to the police or persons who the police are well aware are committing crimes.
The police, including the commissioner himself, have been barred from participating in U.S.-sponsored training programs. The United States has also stopped all assistance to the local police. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.